Bennett's War is the story of Marshall Bennett, a soldier in the Army Ranger Motorcycle Unit who was discharged after he survived an IED explosion in overseas combat. After being told he'd never race professional motocross again, a determined Bennett attempts to conquer the odds. The visual beauty of motocross, the speed, the roar of the engines, and the tension are all in Bennett's War, but these 10 motocross facts will give the film an extra layer of depth and context. Today, we're going to find out everything you need to know about motocross. Although it didn't come into prominence until the 70s, the origins of motocross date back to the early 1920s, and the sport didn't originate in America like most people think. Motocross was born in Great Britain. The English didn't initially call it motocross, though. They called it hare scrambles, and the first known scramble took place in Surrey, South England, in 1924. Those early races had competitors riding street bikes on uneven dirt courses. Motorcycle suspension frames wouldn't hit the sport until the 30s. World War II put a temporary end to what the English were now calling motocross. Racers were either conscripted or they had to abide by strict fuel rationing. After the war ended, the Brits returned home and motocross was born again. It was strictly a British sport until Edison died, an American from Iowa who imported a fleet of small-engine Husqvarna motorcycles from Europe. American racers immediately took to motocross, but they kinda sucked at it compared to the Brits who already had a 10-year head start. Americans stuck to it though, and by the 70s, a new American craze was born. Not many years after they're introduced to the sport, U.S. race promoters upgraded the races to stadium-size events. The first of these stadium races took place on July 8, 1972, at the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum. The event, which was now called the Super Bowl of motocross, almost seemed like a novelty. New fans were unsure how a full-sized dirt track could be constructed and torn down in such a short period of time, but the race was an indisputable success. It drew a crowd of over 29,000 motocross fans, turning it into the biggest motocross event in the United States. Motocross bikes may look the same to the new fan, but aficionados of the sport can tell the difference just by the sound of the engine. It all comes down to the size. A 450 class race features bikes with 450cc engines, which have 10 to 15 times more horsepower than the 250 class. Racing these two engines against one another would be like watching two boxers from different weight classes fight. Motocross and Supercross, they both seem the same, but they're quite different. It all comes down to how the race course is created. Motocross tracks are built on natural land formations. The tracks are long and wide, and are designed to test a rider's skill. On the other hand, Supercross tracks are built in arenas and stadiums, and because space is limited in these venues, the tracks are shorter and narrower. Now we know what the difference between motocross and supercross is, but what the hell does supermoto mean? Well, think of it as the Iron Man of motorcycle racing. Supermoto racing has its riders on three kinds of track surfaces: a flat track made of hard-packed dirt, a track designed with irregular jumps and obstacles of traditional motocross, and a paved tarmac for road racing. It took a while for women to be acknowledged as skilled motocross riders. Sure, there was an event in 1974 called the Powder Puff Motocross Nationals, but you have to wonder how seriously the women were being taken if one of their big races was named after a makeup tool. It wasn't until the American Motorcyclists Association created the Women's Motocross League in 1996 that the ladies were taken seriously. Here's the one odd thing about motocross races. They're not very long. Rather than endurance, motocross races are all about who's the fastest and who can handle the rough terrain they're facing. This recalls the early days of scrambles when the riders had to tear across whatever land was in front of them. Modern motocross consists of two races, which are called motos, with a duration of 30 minutes plus two laps. Since the introduction of motocross in the early 1920s, riders have been reinventing the sport with jaw-dropping feats. One of the most impressive maneuvers that have ever been accomplished was carried out by Caleb Wyatt in 2002. A few months before the X Games, he became the first rider to successfully perform a single backflip on a 250cc motorcycle. The Lucas Oil Pro Motocross Championship, a national series sanctioned by AMA Pro Racing, features 12 races at tracks across the U.S. The series traditionally starts in May with the Hangtown Motocross Classic, the oldest motocross race in the U.S., in Rancho Cordova near Sacramento, California. Started by the Dirt Diggers North Motorcycle Club in 1969, the Hangtown race got its title from the Northern California town of Placerville's Gold Rush nickname. Thanks to the Red Bull and Lucas Oil Pro Motocross, Munster Energy Supercross, and the inclusion of Moto X at the X Games, motocross is one of the world's biggest two-wheel motorsports with races and riders from all over the world. It's a billion-dollar industry that jam-packs stadiums with rabid fans, and going by attendance records, the sport's popularity is nowhere near its peak.